Game industry. A world that exists in a dimension other than our own, where the four goddesses watch and rule over their nations. Last station. The nation ruled by the goddess Blackheart. Loi, the nation ruled by the goddess Whiteheart. Leanbox, the nation ruled by the goddess Greenheart. And Planetune, the nation ruled by the goddess Purpleheart. Though the nations faced the threat of destruction many times, the four goddesses have always banded together to defend game industry. In their current adventure, however, they have been selected as beta testers for a brand new online game. That game is called
Are super cute. I look so heroic. Amazing. Yeah. I tried to make it look just like me in real life, but I might have gotten a little carried away. I'm like a kangaroo, bouncing and jumping, swinging a sword. Oh, yeah. These controls are so comfy. Now then, I should introduce myself. The name's Neptune, the goddess of a little nation called Planetune. Not to mention the series' protagonist. But here, on Four Goddesses Online, I'm but a lowly apprentice paladin. I'm just here taking a break from my work. I'm supposed to play this game with the others today. But where are they? Whoa! Right on cue! Hey! I'm over here!
You're early, Neptune. I didn't think you'd be the first here.
No one's ever late when it comes to playing a new game.
Lon, you're a priest? Oh, wow. It's giving me goosebumps seeing you in that outfit. This is incredible.
Well, I usually play DPS characters in games, so I thought this might be nice for a change.
Hey, so what about my outfit?
Ooh, you're a black knight noir? Interesting choice. Are you burning hot with rivalry against me, the noble paladin?
It's not like that. But there's no way I'd lose to you when it comes to playing an online game.
Goodness, everyone is here already. I apologize for making you wait.
We all just got here. Don't even worry about it. What class are you? That outfit looks so elven.
I have chosen the Enchanter class. It is the only class that bestows attributes upon players depending on the situation.
Your weapon's a rapier? In real life, Noir has a sword, and you have a spear, but here you've switched.
It would seem everyone has changed quite a bit in our short time here. Looking at the balance of our classes, we should make a splendid party.
Alrighty, now that everyone's here, I guess I'll introduce these three here to you guys on the other side of the screen. This this girl's noir. She's the goddess of a little nation known as Dun 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 Last Station. She's usually a bit of a loner, but since she's in our party, I guess she doesn't have to be so lonely this time around. Way to go, Noir! When all is said and done, Noir's sassy wit is a great foil to my finely tuned sense of slapstick. Please, take care of her, everyone. Ahem. Up next is Blonde. She's the goddess of a nation full of snowy wonder, the land of white serenity, the wintry, the wonderful, the lovely Louie. She's a shy, homely girl who loves to read, but once she loses her temper, she's unstoppable. Also, she's occasionally frustrated with her shortcomings in the, chest area, but it seems like her loyal subjects are fine with that. Last up is Vert. Even if she might seem like the calmest of us four, she's a super hardcore gamer. A cut above the rest. As you can see, she's got a lot of, volume. She acts like her older sister sometimes, but she's actually the only one here without a sibling. But anyway, this here lady's also known as the goddess of Leanbox. Please, give them all your support.
Hey, who are you talking to? And I thought I heard something about being lonely.
Hey, what's this about shortcomings?
A sister? Did you mention something about me having a little sister?
Huh? You're just imagining things. You guys are so silly.
Really now?
Come on! Let's stop the chit-chat and finish up these tutorials! Oh, hey! There's a sign over there!
Ugh, where do you think you're going? Don't run away from me, Neptune!
I agree with Neptune. I would like to try the combat here as soon as possible. Come now, Blonde. We should catch up to them.
Good grief. It's like this every time.
Normally, our nations compete against each other, but in this world, we can actually have fun and play together. The party shares a common destiny. There will be no rogue players. We work together. I will personally lend a hand if anyone needs help.
You're the first person I'd suspect of being a solo player and running away from the party.
Yep, I agree.
I'm not sure if I'll be able to keep up with your playing style, Vert. I don't really do all-nighters, so I'll leave that to you.
Not to worry. Just this once, I will not concern myself with completion or ranking lists. I will simply and sincerely explore this new world. I will make new friends and tell others about this wonderful new game. That is my responsibility as one who received an early access invitation from the Four Goddesses Online Management. I take this seriously.
I'm shocked. That MMO monster Vert isn't going to try and be a top-ranking player.
Seriously? I can't believe what I'm hearing. Somebody pick my jaw up off the floor.
Well, playing casually would be a good break from work. And this doesn't feel like a game meant for competition. I can respect that, Vert.
Thank you, Noir. That being said, let us let loose and enjoy ourselves. I believe this episode will take place on a different stage than the one from the previous Four Goddesses Online. I am exploring this world for the first time, and along with all the other beta testers, I am beginning at level 1. I am so thoroughly excited!
Ooh, is that it? Hey, I found the event point for the tutorial!
Wow, what a beautiful view! It's so inspiring! It's just like if we were out sightseeing in the real world!
Our new adventure's about to begin.
Now then, everyone, let us move on towards the new horizon of Four Goddesses Online.
Yeah!
seen this super cool opening. The game's gonna start.
It's been a while since I've played an MMO. I wonder what kind of story this one has.
You said this episode takes place on a different stage. Okay, then tell me this. Are these dungeons not like the ones in the normal Four Goddesses Online verse?
Yes, that is correct. This land is completely new to me, and I have been looking very forward to the element of discovery in this game. An untouched land that stretches out as far as my eyes can see. Ah, oh, I cannot wait!
These kinds of games are the most fun! We'll meet all sorts of new people, too!
I totally agree. The best part about being online is being able to make new friends.
I only play with close friends. But perhaps if I feel like it, maybe I'll try feeling other players in this game.
I'm sure we're gonna run into other players up ahead! All right, let's keep moving on! Hey, there's someone here! Maybe it's the tutorial receptionist!
It's wonderful to meet you, adventurers. My name is Bouquet. I am a guardian spirit, a royal geist, sent by the goddesses, those who guard this world, known as Allsgard, in order to guide your path. As I maintain the chronicle of this land, allow me to explain the story of this place and...
Oh my! Oh dear, oh my! What an absolutely adorable girl! My dear, how would you like to become my younger sister?
What? My vision is filled with bouncy.
Chill out, Bert! What in the world are you doing? You've given the poor girl a nosebleed!
Ugh, bouncy? You gotta be freaking kidding me! No, calm down, Blonde. Let something so stupid get to me. Wait a minute. She's an NPC, but she's reacting to the player's actions in real time?
Ha! So you've noticed. This is another one of the elements in the game that I was becoming very excited about. That element is the game's communication system. NPCs in this world are equipped with a very powerful AI that has the ability to learn.
What? So that means you can just talk normally with a character and they'll carry on a conversation with you? That's super cool!
Doesn't Planetoon specialize in communication AI? How are you not familiar with this?
Does it? I don't know much about that, but Planetoon's technology is number one in game industry, so that makes sense.
Number one? You know, Last Station's tech is unparalleled in basically every other area.
Tech aside, Louis is certainly the best. We have a long history of supporting a wide range of citizens, from children to the elderly.
Now, the real world is currently irrelevant.
Oh, I've never experienced such an intense embrace before. The bouncy can't be taken lightly. I've learned something new.
Bert, you're coming on way too strong! Okay, are you all right?
But my ideal vision, my dream of a little sister has finally appeared before my eyes!
Down, Bert! Just calm down! Let's listen to what she has to say.
Oh, yes! Then, let me collect myself, and I will tell you, adventurers, about this land. Descended from the divine realm into this empty world. Purple Heart, the goddess of fate. Black Heart, the goddess of prosperity. White Heart, the goddess of order. Green Heart, the goddess of fertility. The four goddesses created this world and named it Allsgard. They vowed to protect it. This land is home to the world tree, Lumberday. Otherwise known as the Tree of Life. It is the source of this world's magical power. Its roots spread all across Allsgard, giving life to all things. from the smallest insects to the largest animals. All life was born from Mimbrigain. 1,000 years ago, the goddesses sealed away an invader from the demon realm called the Demon King Jester. He attempted to steal Mimbrigain's magic, but was defeated. The battle took its toll, and the goddesses had to leave Asgard. They created the sacred treasures, in which the remaining power was bestowed. They told the royal geist of that age, my great-great-grandmother, when the world is in danger once again, those carrying our blessings shall appear. Grant them the sacred treasures and call to us. Keep guard of the treasures until that time comes. They retreated to the divine realm and slumbered. We guardian spirits have kept this story close to our hearts. We've passed it down to our descendants for generations. And now, the ones who have received the blessings of the goddesses have arrived! Yes, you all! You are the chosen ones! It is your duty to gather the sacred treasures at Tetu Temple to revive the four goddesses. You must stop the resurrection of the Demon King. Please, only you can save this world. In order to call the goddesses from the divine realm, we need the power of all of you, the chosen ones, as well as the power of the sacred treasures. There are a total of 4 sacred treasures. It will be possible for the goddesses to descend by offering them to the altar. It may become a very difficult journey, but this is something only you, the chosen ones, can do. Our fate lies in your hands.
The models for the 4 goddesses are us, right? I wonder what the goddesses of this world are like. I want to meet them already.
Defeating a demon king, huh? It sounds like a classic fairy tale. It feels exciting to go through a story like this for once.
Now that we know the final boss, where should we go first? You mentioned several names that all sounded rather important.
Yes, past this forest is the city of Wishuel, which is a base for all adventurers. At the heart of the city lies a sacred place called Kotalprim Cathedral, where the goddesses are revered. Please head there first.
I see. Even in this game, it seems to be a very important building. We understand.
Thanks for giving us all that info. Just watch, we're gonna clear the first dungeon in no time.
Yes, of course. I wish you all the best of luck. This forest is a place to test and train adventurers. Please learn how to navigate Asgard at your own pace. That being said, I'll be on my way.
Wait a minute, Bouquet. Will we meet again?
My mission is to guide adventurers. If you are truly the chosen ones, then we shall meet again in the cathedral after your trial.
That is relieving to hear. We have only just met. I do hope we are able to deepen our friendship.
Please go easy on me.
I'm so sorry, Bouquet. You don't have to pay this lady any attention, okay?
Vert should shut her mouth for a while. Let's focus on moving forward.
How regrettable. I suppose it cannot be helped. All right, let us head to the cathedral in Wishuel.
Yeah! Let's get pumped! We'll see you soon, Bouquet!
Bouncy. My memory banks might overheat.
Already. It's time to show my stuff.
Just so you know, it's your own fault if you waste all your energy too soon. Don't come asking me for help later either.
You say that, Noir, but can you even keep up with me? I'm a pro.
Now you've done it. You'll never outgame me, Neptune. Not in a million years.
Well, just don't die out there. You can leave the healing to me.
Now, everyone, let us begin the battle.
Exit? I feel like I'm getting a good handle on the controls.
Pick this up.
Yikes! What was that?
Oh dear. It seems we have a guest.
Are we starting the boss battle? Well, it's only the first dungeon, so I'm sure we'll be fine.
Why, yes. Our bare hands would be more than enough for a tutorial boss.
Yeah. That's very nice and all, but please fight with your weapons.
My instincts are telling me to go in swinging against the boss. But for now, I'll do my best to help with support.
Is everyone ready? Let's go!
Da-na-na-na! I picked this up! We did it! I picked this up!
Fire!
Let's go!
Yeah!
We can't hit!
Yeah!
Was as easy as tea time cake. Now then, we are almost at the hub for adventurers. Wish you well.
Let's head back and rest. Here we are at Wish You Well.
Wow, look at all the facilities this town has. This really is a hub for adventurers.
Yeah, I'd really like to take a look at all the shops.
Let us not forget to visit our checkpoint, the cathedral. Oh, I do wish to see Bouquet as soon as possible.
Well, I'm sure there's an event at the cathedral. We can check that out first, then take our time looking around the city.
Is it all right if I pick? Let me think of what to do.
A new version of the city. It is so refreshing to see an updated cityscape in Four Goddesses Online.
I can appreciate that. Enjoying the cities and fields in any game is a super important fun factor. You walk around in them all day, after all.
My Neptune, you understand quite well, don't you? Yes, it is fun to be immersed in the environment of this world. That is precisely how it becomes a beloved game that one can spend so much time with.
I see. That's how it becomes nicer in this world instead of real life. And then you can no longer escape.
Are you addicted to online gaming, Neptune? You know, the first step to recovery is admitting you have a problem.
No way.
Denial. The lack of self-awareness is a textbook symptom. It might be too late for you, buddy.
Say it ain't so. Does this mean I'm going to end up like Vert? Yeesh!
Goodness, is it so horrible to be like me? How very sad.
Okay, okay. Enough with the fake tears.
Well, jokes aside, I can understand how you can lose yourself just walking around in a game like this. It's a beautiful world.
This is the bulletin board. It is an essential tool for any kind of online game. You can request or search for parties, ask for strategy tips, or simply chat. Your game's world can expand greatly depending on how you use it.
Ah, so you can interact with other players here. Let's use this to our advantage.
Wow. If we use this bulletin board, even someone as lonely as you could make, like, 100 friends, Noir.
Hey! Who's lonely? You take that back!
Good grief. Leave it to Noir to lose her cool.
Oh, speaking of, Blondier, the realm of online gaming is quite coarse. It would serve you well to build a tolerance towards instigation here.
Yeah, would it? And just who's the one who's always instigating me?
This is the Guild. It is an organization where adventurers help each other out. Here, various quests are collected from the residents of Allsgard. Some of these quests will progress the main story as well.
So we accept a quest, fulfill its requirements, then report it. That's how we complete the quests, right? Lots of games have quests. They're even in our real lives. But hey, can't live with them, can't live without them.
Whether in a game or in real life, the importance of work doesn't change for some people.
La 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 la, I can't hear you!
Welcome to the guild. You've accepted the quest. Good luck. 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 Be careful out there.
This seems to be a general store run by an NPC. We can purchase recovery items and equipment.
I'm sure everyone out there knows this already, but buying the equipment is only half the battle. Don't forget to equip it!
We can sell items we don't need anymore, too. Let's remember that if we ever need more funds during our journey.
Come again. Welcome to the guild. Be careful out there.
treasure's mine.
Welcome to the guild. Finished the quest, huh? Good job. Finished the quest, huh? Good job. Finished the quest, huh? Good job. Be careful out there.
Let's give it our all.
So this is the cathedral.
A place like this can make you feel a little tense. The atmosphere is so solemn.
Yeah, but for a priest like me, this feels like home.
Ah, look, look! They have statues of the goddesses! Wowee! So pretty! I mean, the other ones look nice too, but Purple Heart's looking real good!
Really? I think Blackheart's statue is the most magnificent. It clearly exhibits the perfect balance of charm and elegance.
Maybe.
But isn't Whiteheart's statue just lovely? The designer who created this has fantastic taste. It's quite inspiring.
Blonde, my dear, if it's a muse you're after, please feast your eyes upon Greenheart's enchanting figure. Aren't you inspired by her voluptuousness?
Hey, why are you only saying that to me?
Now, all that aside, it looks like this really is the cathedral that worships the goddesses.
Chosen ones, welcome to Caudalprim Cathedral. I'm so very happy to see you all again.
Oh dear, oh my bouquet! Oh,
I am simply overjoyed to see you as well.
Bouquet, have you ever considered that our names sound very sisterly? Do you believe it is possible we were separated at birth?
This feels softer than last time.
Folks, it appears Vert is pulling a new one out of the playbooks and attempting a much softer approach this round. Let's see what happens.
All right, break it up, break it up! Let's get on with the event, ladies!
Your nose is bleeding again, Bouquet. Ugh, let me heal you.
I'm sorry.
No need to apologize. Hey, since you've shown up again, does that mean we've cleared the trial?
Yes. I'm now convinced that you really are the Chosen Ones. The ones that shall be entrusted with the great mission. I would now like to finish what I started explaining to you last time. I wish for you to know how to save this world.
Yes, please. Go right ahead.
Your mission is to usher in the goddesses in order to save this world. I've told you this much, correct?
Correct. In order to defeat the Demon King, we will need the power of the goddesses.
Wait. Why can't the goddesses just come down on their own? Don't they know the world's in danger?
This is what I'd like to tell you next. Allow me to explain more about the goddesses and the Demon King. When the goddesses descend to Allsgard, they expend much of their power. This was never an issue, thanks to the restorative magic of Lienverdae. After defeating the Demon King, however, Lienverdae was unable to restore the power they spent. They were forced to return to the Divine Realm to heal. They should have recovered by now, but the Demon King cursed them. They are unable to wake up by their power alone. There is only one way to wake them. The sacred treasures must be used to build a rainbow bridge and travel to the Divine Realm. The four sacred treasures are the treasures of this world. The amethyst glass, the black diamond sword, the moonstone hairpin, and the emerald mirror. The treasures were sealed away in various lands so they wouldn't be used for evil. Only the Chosen Ones should have been able to release the seals. But a powerful dark magic has destroyed the seals, and two of the sacred treasures were taken by those working for the Demon King. The allied forces of the Paladins and the Black Knights have been trying to retrieve them, but normal people cannot fight against powerful monsters. And so, by offering the four sacred treasures to the altar, the gate to the sanctuary and the Divine Realm will open, and the goddesses can return.
Okay, two of the sacred treasures are still sealed away, right? Do you know where we can find them?
Yes, two of the sacred treasures are still sealed away. One is at the Logi Mountain, and the other is at the Yiar Forest.
We should definitely start by heading to one of these places since we know the sacred treasures are there.
Then let us pay a visit to Logi Mountain at once.
That was a quick response. Any reason for that, Vert? I'm sure either one would be fine.
Because if there is a mountain, it must be climbed. My heart is telling me we must go to Logi Mountain. That is all there is to it. Also, if I may add, there's simply the recommended level progression of the dungeons, so...
Your heart is telling you to go? Really? You sure it isn't that rare metal collector in you telling you to go there?
Absolutely not. Now, let us hurry onwards to save Bouquet and the world. And once we gather all of the sacred treasures, the beautiful union of the goddesses and my younger sister will take place.
An incident has occurred in the cathedral. Bouquet is being drooled over by a female player.
When the sacred treasures are gathered, what sort of bouncy fate awaits me? I feel so anxious, my heart is already pounding.
This is ridiculous. I hope she isn't a bad influence on the communication AI.
I won't let her do anything weird, so don't worry. Don't let her get to you, Bouquet. It'll be a great help if you could advise us as we progress.
Right, of course. I look forward to our next meeting.
A sister is an elusive shadow, and the more I chase her, the farther she runs. Perhaps instead of pursuing her, I should try drawing her in.
Ah, right. To ensure my feelings reach Bouquet, let us pray here at the cathedral.
Your feelings aside, it would be good to see what sort of functions this place has.
To the cathedral.
Everyone, let us go.
Now then, I wonder what sort of monsters are here. I hope we don't run into any strong ones.
Nah, we're fine. Don't even worry about it.
Oh? And just how can you be so sure?
Because this is so early in the game. Super buff monsters wouldn't even show up right now.
Nah, you keep letting your guard down like this, and you're gonna be the first one to eat dirt.
Now, I will make sure to support everyone using the instincts I have gained through many long years of gaming. There's no need to worry.
Ooh, as expected of our resident gamer junkie. So reliable.
According to Bouquet, there should be a sacred treasure sealed in this mountain. Let us gather our strength and move onward.
Ha! Found an item!
What is the matter?
With this! You!
Here you!
Get your chance!
This might be getting really bad.
There!
What?
Nepco
has about this?
This will end it.
Useless.
This will end it.